This video explains how to draw camp profile in case of the offset follower. Now the various specifications are given over here. The outstroke is 90 degree with uniform velocity. Then dwell for the next 45 degree of camp rotation. Return stroke is also of 90 degree of cam rotation with uniform velocity and dwell for the rest of the period. Minimum radius of the cam is 3 cm. Then offset is provided on the right hand side of 10 mm and lift or stroke of the follower is 3 cm. Now on x axis we take crank angle and on y axis we take the lift or stroke of the follower. Now on x-axis, we have taken this theta O, that is outstroke, is of 90 degree. Then by taking some suitable scale of this displacement diagram, on x-axis we are having the scale that we have chosen is 1 centimeter is equal to 15 degree. So 90 divided by 15, so this length will be of 6 centimeter. And we have divided that 6 centimeter length into 6 equal parts. Then on y-axis we are having 1 cm is equal to 1 cm of the lift or stroke of the follower. So this length, the stroke of the follower is 3 cm. So this length will be of 3 cm. So 90 divided by 15, that is 6 cm, and we have divided into 6 equal parts. Outstroke dwell is 45 degrees. So 45 divided by 15, that is 3 cm. And return stroke is 90, so 90 divided by 15, again that is of 6 cm, and we have divided that return stroke also into 6 equal part as shown over here, that is 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 and 12. Now join this diagonal, it will intersect these vertical lines at A, B, C, D, E and F. Then there is a 12 period over here of 45 degree. The dwell means what? The follower will remain in the same position for 45 degree rotation of the cam. And then return stroke, the follower will start coming down for this rest of the period. So again, join this diagonal as it is a return stroke. Again, these vertical lines, they will intersect it at G, then H, I, J, K. So this 1A distance, this 2B distance, 3C, 4D, 5E and 6F, these distances. For the outstroke as well as for return stroke, this 6F, 7G, 8H, GI, 10J, 11K, these distances, they are important for drawing the cam profile. Now, in the next animation, we have considered this outstroke. So, outstroke is of 90 degree, that is by scale it is 6 cm length. And then we have divided it into 6 equal part, and let us see what will be the procedure for drawing the cam profile in case of the offset follower. So as seen earlier, we are dividing this outstroke into 6 equal parts, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Now project this point on the opposite side and draw the vertical lines. Now join this diagonal. These vertical lines, they will intersect this diagonal at this particular point, that is A, B, C, D, E and F as we have seen earlier. Now draw the cam circle of 3 cm because minimum radius of the cam is 3 cm. Then draw the offset circle which is of 1 cm radius. Now draw a line from this point, vertical line, so that it will intersect this cam circle at point E and join this with the center of the cam. Now important point over here is that from this blue line we have to mark the angle. For example, in this case this outstroke is of 90 degree. So we have to divide this camp circle into 6 equal parts. So 90 divided by 6, that is 15 degree. And those angles we have to mark from this blue line as a reference. So this 15 degree we have taken over here separately on the another circle just for the convenience. And then this arc length is taken over here to divide the camp into 6 equal parts. You can do it directly also. So now we are dividing this camp circle into 6 equal parts as shown over here. Draw the tangent from this point to this opposite circle. So we have drawn the tangent from these points to this offset circle. So these are all the tangents which we have drawn from this point on this circle. And now transfer this distance, that is 1A distance on this line, this 2B distance over here on this line, then 3C distance on this third tangent line, 4D distance over here, and then draw a smooth curve passing through this. So in this way we can draw the camp profile in case of the offset follower. So mark the point of intersections. And draw a smooth curve passing through these particular points. The same procedure can be adopted for the return stroke also.